The first image on your left was taken July 2012 of myself. Yes, probably shocking, right? Well, back then, I used to go to the gym on a regular basis. The more weight I lift, the bigger muscles I get. As you load a specific muscle site in your body, your muscle will start to adapt it, resulting in muscles growth. And just like muscles, bones remodel and reshape according to the load applied on a particular site. If the load increases on a particular bone site, your bone will increase its mass. And the inverse is true. The reduction of load on a bone will cause the bone to adapt itself by reducing its mass. This process is known as Wall's law. Let's keep that in mind for now. In a bone fracture fixation, a traditional metallic implant plate is used in order to reduce the fracture gap and allow bone healing. In a metallic implant used, such as titanium or stainless steel is used, is a stiff and rigid. It is 5 to 6 times stiffer than a human bone. The big difference in the properties between metallic plate and bone disturbs the bone underneath the plate, causing it to reshape and remodel according to the load applied. The reshape and model, so the metallic implant acts like a gym dumbbell in which it increases the bone mass underneath the plate and causes low bones to the further bone region. Clinical studies reported the bone mass reduction is up to 50% of the femur bone, which is the thigh bone, after 5 to 7 years prior to implanting. Hence, when it comes to bone, it is not as cool as building muscles. In the long term, it could cause osteoporosis, which is low bone mass diseases. It could cause implant plate loosening and delay in the healing process. And here is where my challenge comes in. In my research thesis, I'm proposing a new green composite material to replace traditional metallic implant. Green composite material is made of a flax fiber that is extracted from a flax plant. We found that this material has a properties close to human bone properties in which it significantly increases the load level in the surrounding bone while implanted. I hope to provide a lifelong substitute to human bone that can be integrated to one's body and provide a sustainable and environmentally friendly material. Thank you.